Hey y'all, it's Taylor from Tattoo Teacher Plans. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. I'm so glad you're here. Today's the first installment of my October haul, and I have four shops here, and I'm excited because they're like holiday themed and fun. So let's get into it. First, I'm going to start with Jessica Hartz. You know I love her shop, and she's just extra special to me because she's been just super supportive of me and my channel. And she also sent me a bunch of stuff for my planner club, which was so nice. But I'm really excited for this kit. This is called Reading Night, or Reading Night In. And this is the mini kit, and this is like made for me. I love this. And a whole bunch of people tagged me when she showed this art because it is totally me. You've got books, you've got a cat, you've got snacks, pizza, coziness. I mean, it's perfect, and I love it. The color scheme is also really beautiful. I don't know when I'm going to use this. I'm thinking maybe January, but it's just really pretty, and I like it a lot. That bottom washi is gorgeous, a little pizza flag. It's just perfect for me. I also added on the Reading Night In foil in gold because it has a Jane Austen quote. And y'all know I love Jane Austen. I just think it's so cute. And like, it's kind of an anytime kit. Like, it's got the cozy element to it, but I think I could use it whenever. And I like it a lot. So also, I added on these pressure cooker, just to mark when I'm using my Instant Pot. This is on some matte paper, and I really like these. So I'm glad I added those. That is everything from Jessica Hartz for now. And let's go to Shameless Stickers. I got some Halloween things in here, and I'm excited to use them. Super cute. Okay, this made me laugh, like, a whole lot when I opened this, because I must have not read the description. These are tiny. Like, they're called teeny tinies for a reason. I thought they were going to be small, but, like, these are so, so little. And I don't know how much I'm going to be able to use them. I got them for my plum paper, and I guess I've moved down to the A5, so that's good. But I got these to match the colors for October and going into December, November and December. But these are real small. I'm sure it's my fault for not reading the description. But they just looked bigger in the pictures. I got three of the yellow rainbow just so I had some different options and shades. And then I did the same thing in the blue rainbow. And then I got, here's the little card that came with my order. I got the It's Fine, I'm Fine stickers. And then this sheet from the Halloween release. I just thought this was super fun. This is called Here Comes Halloween, and it's just a sampler of like a lot of different fun things. So cute. I love these little, you know, candy corns with the faces. Oh, so cute. These are going to be really fun in my my plum paper. Maybe in my memory planner too. So cute. All right, that's all from Shameless Stickers. Next up is Sadie Stickers. So this order was for this kit specifically, and I was going to add on some more, but I'm trying to only buy what I know I will use, and this one had a spot in my lineup. So this is called Trick or Treat. It's a photography kit, but it's got some foil overlays, and it's just really cute. I really like this one here. And the number, I just love her attention to detail. So cute. And the colors I thought were kind of fun and different. That color of orange is so pretty. And I loved the bottom washi. I think that's so cute. So this is in rose gold foil. And then I added on the decorative sheet for this kit just to add some fun things to the sidebar. And I really like these boxes in my memory planner. So that is Trick or Treat. And then I've got, what, three envelopes from the Crafty Banana? I got in quite a few orders here. So let's see what's in this little one. This is coffee cups, I bet. Yes. Okay. These are the Witch's Brew, I think. Yes. These are so cute. Here is the little freebie with the stamps, the fall stamps. Okay, so I got a couple of the Witch's Brew, which are just fun fall colors. Then I got this one for my sister. So this is the Gryffindor coffee cups. I'm not into Harry Potter, but she is. And I wanted to show these to you, so I'm sharing them with you now. The colors are really fun. Definitely match what I know about Harry Potter, which is not much. And then we've got the Magical Coffee Cups in Brave. I got these mainly for the colors because I don't have some of these colors, like this bright yellow and this like grayish green, just kind of unique colors. And then I've got the Luke's coffee cups in the fall edition. So they're orange and so cute. And I got two of those. So that's all of my fall coffee cups. Love those. Well, they're not fall. They're more like Halloween inspired. And then we've got some more kits. Okay, these two are minis. I got these mainly to try in my Plum Paper. So this is the coffee kit. And both of these are kit two. So I decided to go against the scene kits because that would obviously take up way too much space. But I can totally make these work. So even if I didn't use all of them, like, I could use some on one side. I don't know. I'm just going to play around with it and see what happens. So here are the 8 full boxes. And then I can cut down this washi, I think. Use some of the little things. Just kind of have fun with it. Got some cute deco. And then I have some boxes here. And then here is the freebie that comes with that kit. Really cute. So I'm just gonna see what happens. I don't know when I'm gonna use this, but I think it may be November. We'll see. I'm very excited to try out a little mini kit in my Plum Paper. Okay, she sent me a couple of my freebies, which I absolutely adore. This is my current fall freebie. I love it so much. It's perfect. And then this is the Downton collection, the Abbey collection. I just finished watching Downton Abbey all the way through again. I need to watch the movie because it was really good too. But I watched the whole series. It's just so good. This is beautiful. And I could definitely use like these two full boxes on one side and these on the other. And I think it might look kind of cool. Here's the bottom washi. And then I could definitely incorporate the deco and some of these icons and things like that. I just want to see what happens. So here is the little freebie that comes with the Downton kit. Super cute. I will definitely watch Downton Abbey all the way through again. I've done it like maybe 3 times. I love that show. It's so good. If you've never watched it, definitely check it out. It's on Netflix. It's a beautiful show. All right. And then here are my Halloween kits, kind of. So I did the same thing as I was doing with these. I got the little mini kit. So I thought this would be kind of fun to try for the week of October 3rd. I'm not a super like Mean Girls fan, but I do think that this is really cute and it has Fox and Pip deco. So I think I might try this next week in my Plum Paper and we'll just see what happens. I don't know, but it's really cute and I thought it would be kind of fun to mix it up. So that is the mini kit. This collection doesn't even go here. And then here is the freebie that goes with this kit. All right. Then I have, I'm going to put this off to the side over here because I'm using it soon. Then I have the Another Glorious collection. It makes me sick. And some candles. So this is Hocus Pocus themed. Let me show you these first. So here's another one of my freebies. I love it. And then I got a restock for me of the Black Flame candle collection. These are so fun. I always use the Black Flames out of both of them. So cute. And then here is the kit. It's called Another Glorious Collection. It makes me sick. Here are the full boxes. Don't know if I'm going to have room to use this year. I just don't know. I'm not sure. And then the deco is so cute. I like the colors too. And pretty lace bottom washi. And then here is the little freebie. I love that little cupcake. It's so cute. So that is the Hocus Pocus related collection from the Crafty Banana. And that's it for this section of the haul. So I'll see you in a minute for some more. So these are the items I have for this second part of the haul. So let's just get this one out of the way. I repurchased this from Amazon. This is my favorite tape runner. It's just the best, in my opinion. I use it for my memory planning, for attaching my photos to the page, and it works great. It is permanent, and it is acid-free, I believe. Yes. So it's photo safe. So I love this. I get it from Amazon. I'll link it below. Okay, next up is some new planner covers from Plum Paper. So I've switched to the A5. If you didn't see that, I will link my last month's haul so you can check that out. So I had some credits and I went ahead and purchased a couple of covers for my A5. So this one I thought would be really cute for spring. I just put my initials right there in the middle and it's just kind of like cutesy and abstract and fun. Then I got this one for fall, and I'm actually going to put this one on my planner right after I finish filming this. I just think it's so cute. And I love that like chartreuse, deep golden yellow color. It's so pretty. Again, just put my initials in the middle. And then this one is actually an exact replica of one that I already got for my 7x9. And I just loved it. I love this saying, "All roads lead home for the holidays," and the colors in this I thought are just beautiful. So this will be like my December cover. This will be my fall cover, and then I'll switch it up in January and either go back to my leopard or try out this one for spring. So that is my cover purchase order from Plum Paper for my A5 vertical priorities planner. Then let's go to Fox and Pip. Man, I have not ordered from Fox and Pip in forever. So I was really excited to place an order finally. I don't know what I was waiting on, but she had a bunch of new releases and I dropped some money. So let me show you these. These are new to me. These like bigger sheets. I thought these would be really fun in my Plum Paper vertical priorities. This one's called Dream. It's just a little journaling sheet, and I just think it's super, super cute. This might be fun in, like, January. And then Love Letters. This is beautiful. Just really cute. And I'm just loving my style in that planner right now with using, like, decoration. Here's the current week. Using decorative elements, but just keeping it pretty functional. So I love the balance that I'm finding in that planner right now, and these are a perfect fit for that. Then let's get into the character stickers. So here is the little thank you freebie right there. And then I got some minis. So I got the, oh, it doesn't have the name on there. But these are like the snacks one. That's cute. And then the sitting with the laptop. I wish I knew what the names of these were, but I don't. And then I've got this one, the little workout sheet. I thought that was really cute in the mini format. This would be good in my Plum Paper. And then the boba, because I'm just obsessed with boba tea right now. And then I've got some bigger sheets. True crime all the time. These are just kind of neutral and cute. And you'll know I love my true crime. We've got running on empty and running on full. So I just thought these were really cute for my memory planner to mark in, you know, days that are hard or when I'm stressed, and then days when my heart is full. We've got road tripping. I really like the size of these. Here's proud of me. Cute. I don't think we say often enough how proud of ourselves we are. Then I got once or twice a year. This sheet is just like super functional. I think it's just really, really good. I like it a lot. And then if you're a One Tree Hill fan, you'll know what this is. N plus H. So that's Nathan plus Haley. He gives her this little bracelet out of a Cracker Jacks box pretty early on in their relationship. And it just kind of follows them throughout the whole show. This, I thought this would be cute to mark in, like, listening to the One Tree Hill podcast. I can't remember what it's called right now. Drama Queens. That's it. But I could, like, write Drama Queens in the middle of it. I've got a hiking trail. Really cute. Check-in. Anxiety tracker, again, for my memory planner, just marking, like, what level I'm at. My anxiety was really high in September. I'm kind of feeling like it's coming down, hopefully. Read together. I got this for me and my nephew, which is perfect because I have brown hair and he has black hair. Really? These are funny. And there's a bunch of them on the page, which is good. Kind of cool. And then I've got the big I work out kind of reformat. It used to just have like one type of girl on there, but I like the variety here. So that is everything from Fox and Pip. This was a lot. Like, I don't think I had ordered in over a year. So it was nice to kind of just fill my cart with things that I've been wanting to get for a while. But I love all of these. They're so cute. I have an album dedicated solely to Fox and Pip, so I'm glad to add these to my collection. Then this is a new to me shop called it's like Pepper. Is it Poor Little Pepper? Is that, I mean, that's in big letters, I think. But the artist who does the art for this, oops, I'm just keep dropping things, is Lindsay Hopkins, and Poor Little Pepper is the name of her shop. But she also has another, like, art handle, too. These are just so cute. She lives in the UK, I believe. So here are the little freebies that she threw in. These are very, like, kind of in the same vibe as Fox and Pip. Those are cute. I love bread, so I feel like I should use these to mark days when I miss bread. And then we've got the little Starbucks one. Cute. Okay, so this is what I got from her. Four different sheets. This one is the fall edition. I thought this was super cute. I love the colors too. They're kind of like muted. And then we've got the winter edition, which has tons of cute things. And then the fall edition with the just the her character. And you can choose your hair color and skin color, I believe. I can't remember exactly. And then this is the spring edition. So I'm assuming she's going to come out with like a summer one too. But I just thought these were a fun thing to add to my seasonal sticker collection. I do have a video where I shared all of my seasonal stickers. I did it last year. So I will try to remember to link that down below. But this is just really cute. I just like these a lot. Just really fun and kind of different, but still like in the same, like I think they would match really well with Fox and Pip. So that's my order from Poor Little Pepper. And then we've got, according to Allie, of course, she is like basically my favorite shop for my plum paper. So I got a couple of washies along with some stickers. Basically, I'm just using her for almost all of my spreads now. So I got four different washi tapes. I just thought these were really cool looking. So this one is white with black outlined hexagons on it. I think this is like seasonless and kind of cool. Then I've got this one with the little, what animal is this? It's like some kind of, is it cheetah? No, leopard? I don't know. Anyway, this animal print, I just like it. It's kind of neutral too. Then I've got this one. What is this? Terrazzo. This is just really cool. And I think this will be good through the winter. Just very like kind of neutral and different. And then this one is very much like fall going into winter. I don't know if you can see that very well. But it's got leaves. It's got a navy background, pine cones, and several different kinds of leaves. So I just really like this one a lot, and I'm going to be digging into it soon. Then I got some stickers, of course. So let's go into here. I always love her packaging. It's always just very classy and cute. All right, so here is the freebie that came with my order. I really love her lettering style. This is so cute, and I think I have to use this for the week of Thanksgiving. It's just adorable. I love it so much. This is just so cute. And then I got the two of the alcohol ink sheets. So these are on clear paper. I've got the sage, which I just think this is a beautiful color. And it's got like gold fleck accents. And then the khaki, just really pretty. I need to use these. I've got one that I never used in the summertime, but I just think they're so cool and I need to use them. Okay, then I've got inked true crime. Love this. I'm gonna have to do like a whole week of true crime. That's so cute. And then the beaming blooms, which are these sunflowers. I just thought these were really, really pretty. I took my nephews and my sisters and my mom to the pumpkin farm recently, and they had a whole field of sunflowers. You could go and pick them, but it was just a few days past the end of the season, so I didn't get to pick any sunflowers, but now I have some. So that is everything from According to Allie, and I will be back in a minute to show you some more. All right, let's wrap up this haul. I've got like five shops here that we need to go through. Six? I don't know. Let's see. Let's start with Jet Pens because I have quite a few things here. Let me just move these over just a little bit. Okay, so let's start with some repurchases. This is going to come as no surprise to anyone. I think these are all black. I don't think I got any gray. I was going to try the gray again, but I think I've given up on finding the gray that I want. But these are the Pentel Energel Infreeze. These are my current favorite pen in 0.7. I just love these pens. I've actually started using them at work too. So I just need like all the pens. I also got a couple of refills for when the barrels are still good, but I want to use refills. So that's what I was initially after when I made this Jet Pens order. And then I found this brown Pentel Energel. This is just really cool and I can't wait to try it out. It's just a dark brown and it might be kind of fun to use this for a couple of weeks. And then I got some Tombows. So these colors I really just like just went with. I just looked for colors that I want and I have wanted in the past few weeks, but don't necessarily have. And I just grabbed these. So the peach one here is $8.73. I was kind of thinking about like the modern color scheme too, but really just with this one and the blue maybe. This green, this pretty like jade green is $3.46. This green, this chartreuse green is $1.26. Then I've got this pretty blue. It's like a cornflower blue and it's $5.26. And then this pretty gray, it's like a warm gray and it is N79. So these I just wanted to add to my collection. And then these just kind of jumped to my cart. These are the metallic jelly rolls and I just, really my gold jelly roll dried up. And then I lost my silver. And then I don't know what happened. Then I got the rose gold or the copper. I think this is the copper. Wish the name was on it. And then I don't think I got another one, but maybe I did. I don't know. I don't know what happened. These just kind of jumped into my cart when I was thinking, hey, I should replace my gold pen here. I swear these are two different colors, but maybe not. They're probably exactly the same and I just accidentally ordered two. Yeah, that's what I did. Okay, so that is my Jet Pens order. It's just a lot of pens and markers and I'm happy to have these. Man, Jet Pens is just like such a good deal. Okay, let me go to this shop here, which I can't even remember what it was. Oh, Saucy Stickers Co. I haven't ordered from her in a while. I think since I was using B6 kits, but I saw these. I think that this will work really well on my plum paper vertical priorities. So she does these journaling pages and I've seen a lot of shops starting to do these kinds of journaling pages. And I just think this is a really cool option for me in that A5 plum paper. So I got the Holly sheet and it's just got a fun mix of like things I can write on and then like kind of washi strips or like scrap stickers. I don't even know what to call those. Along with some decorative things. I just think it's going to be really cool to make spreads with these. This one I thought I might use in either December or January. This is the Evergreen Sheet, and I just thought it was really pretty. Oh, I love that there's just like a good mix. And I've ordered from a couple more shops, which will be in the next haul, of these journaling pages to see like how I can make it work, because I think it's going to be really good and cool. So those are what I was after. And then I got Katie's freebie here. And then she also threw in this little silver freebie right there. So super cute from Saucy Stickers Co. And I'm definitely keeping these on my radar for like future purchases. Finding some more of these journaling sheets. If you have journaling shops that you would like to recommend, please let me know down below. I'm very curious. Okay, this is an order from Sadie Stickers, a $2 Tuesday order, because I cannot resist. I don't buy as much as I used to, but this one was a good one. So this is a lot of holiday stuff, and I just thought these were so cute and pretty. I got everything in gold because that was just what I was feeling like I would use. So we've got the Holiday Mini Swoop. Cute. I can put these on like full boxes or even half boxes. The String Light Divider number 2. So cute. The Tree Date Numbers. These are the solid ones. And then I also got the outline ones. And then the Tree Mini Deco. I just thought those were so cute. And these could replace like bows. I could use these instead. Just so cute. And then I got some bottom washi here. So I got the String Light 1, which is just like the kind of swirly one. And then this one is a little bit more intricate. This is String Light 2. So I just thought these would be fun options for adding to really anything. I could use these guys on full boxes. And then these are like individual strips. So I could like layer a couple of them, or I could just use them like across the top. I don't know. I'm just really excited to use these because these are just like individual strips, if you can see that. I think that's such a great idea. Really like versatile. Okay, so that's everything from Sadie's Stickers. And then let's go to the Crafty Banana. This is super fun stuff. I think that I am going to do a spread with like family or holiday traditions, and I'm gonna like crowdsource some ideas for you guys and make a fun like fake spread like I did in the summertime. Maybe I'll just make that like a seasonal thing. But that's what I had in mind for this kit, because Brianna had the best idea either last year or the year before to use the Friends collection, but then add some things, which I'll show you in a minute. Oh, I'm so excited. And make it a Thanksgiving Friends themed kit, which I think is just so fun. So I got kit 2. So I've got the scene, but I also have some full boxes here. And then here is the bottom washi and extra full box, day covers, checklists. The deco is just so cute. I love it so much. And then you got some boxes here. And then little things and headers. Some functional things. And the weekend banner and some more functional things. Oh, I just love this. And then here is the freebie, which is so cute. I love her freebies. They're just so fun. Like the candles, Monica Clean, Rachel's Trifle, Central Perk, and On a Break. So cute. Okay, so what I did was add on a couple of things to this. So let me show you that so it like kind of makes sense. I have done this before, and I think I'm going to do a video on like kits I've used before so you can like see the differences over the years. I think that might be kind of fun. So I got the glitter sampler to use with this kit, and then she threw in the pie. This is like a big sticker. And then here's my freebie. So cute. I love it so much. And then I got 2 of the Thankful for Pie sheets. So I'm going to use these to mix in with the deco and everything in this kit and make it a Friends Thanksgiving kit. That's just, I love it. I can't wait to do that again. So there's that. And then I also got the Thanksgiving mini kit too. And I thought I might try to use this in my plum paper. I don't know. I'm just gonna like experiment. But I thought that since there's not a big seam, I could use these like throughout the week. And there's some washi. So this is the mini kit. So it's small, but like I think this might be the perfect size for my plum paper. I'm just kind of excited about it. So I won't be able to use the weekend banner, but I can definitely use like the boxes, the icons, the deco. I can use the little things, definitely the washi, and then the full boxes for sure. So I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just really excited about it. Here is the freebie for the Thanksgiving collection. Again, you have the themed candles. So cute. So if you want to order with the Crafty Banana, these kits will be gone by the time you see this video. But she's got her holiday kits coming up soon. So you can use code Taylor when you check out with her and save a little bit of money and get my cute freebie, which we will be doing a holiday freebie. So stay tuned for that. All right. That's everything from the Crafty Banana. Let me get this stuff out the way. Okay, this is kind of a funny story. So I ordered this kit way back in like September, I think. And it somehow got here. It said it was delivered, but it wasn't in my box. I talked to my mail people and they said it was delivered, but it wasn't. So I had to order it again because I really had it in my head that I wanted to use this kit because I think it is gorgeous and it's very like traditional Christmas, but with like a little bit of fun with the pink. I don't know. I just love this so much. So this was a very expensive kit when you add all that up, but I am excited to have this and use this in my memory planner. It's called Brunchmas from Caress Press. Here are the beautiful full boxes. I think it's so cute. I just love this. The artwork is so pretty. And then the colors are super fun. You've got this like lighter green and the pink kind of offset the more traditional colors. This is the mini kit, by the way. Then I got, or we have the boxes and the glitter headers. Her kit format is my favorite right now. It's just so good. The bottom washi, you got an extra box. And then the deco is so cute. I just love this so much. I'm so happy that I was finally able to get it. Here are the extra two boxes, which I love this one. I might have to use that. Oh, that's so cute. One Christmas, I bought myself a KitchenAid mixer just to treat myself. And it's huge. It's one of the like professional ones where you like, it's like holds so much, but I love it so much. All right. That is from Caress Press. Okay, last shop here is from EC. So I got a couple of things here. This I'm actually not going to show you because it's a gift. I don't know why I included it here. I'm going to put it over here. I don't think she would watch this, but if she did, I wouldn't want her to see it. Okay, this is just a random sheet that I got for my teacher planner. I really find these sheets to be really fun in that planner. And I just love this pattern. I can't remember, and it doesn't say what it's called or anything. And I think I threw away my packing slip. Oops. Anyway, I just thought this was a really beautiful little abstract pattern, and I really like the colors. So there's that. And then this was what I was after. So I saw someone post about this. This is the Stand Up Padfolio. And it's got like a faux suede leather cover. So what I've been using lately for my memory planner notes is a notepad from Sadie Stickers. Here's what it looks like this. And I really like this. It's worked really well for me, but I am running out. And so I need another option. And this is one that I saw that I thought would work pretty well because of the way that it's constructed and the layout and everything. Okay, so it's upside down. Here is the front, and it has like a little trifold thing here, and I'll show you how that works in a minute. And then when you open it, here is the notepad itself. And I love that it's lined, and I really like that it has the dates at the top, which this one didn't. And then I would forget to put it on there, and then at the beginning of every single memory plan with me, I would be like, I don't know what week this is. It also has this section here for anything else I wanted to add to my journaling section for in my memory planner. I probably wouldn't use the to-dos, but I might find some kind of use for that. But I just thought this was a really good format for me. The size is a little big, However, here's what I thought was really cool. When I am working on my memory spreads, I can fold this back and lay it like this on my desk, and I'll be able to see everything really clearly when I'm actually making that spread. So it's like just, I think it's what I need. However, if you have a favorite weekly notepad, and here's the important thing. I need Saturday and Sunday to be separate. A lot of the notepads put it like Saturday slash Sunday, and I don't like that. I need them to be separate. If you have a recommendation for a notepad that has some kind of format like this with the separate weekend days, let me know down below, because I know that this one's not going to last forever. This has like, I think 25 sheets on it, but eventually I'll have to get another one. So let me know if you know of any more of these, but I really like this. It's a little large, but I think I can leave it up like this on my desk, and then I won't forget to fill this out, because that also happens. Like, this will get shuffled underneath something else on my desk, and then I'll forget to fill it out, and then it's like really hard to remember stuff. So I think this is really cool, and it was from the Focus collection, which I really enjoy. I like the style of it, so I'm just excited for this padfolio. I didn't know that was a thing, but apparently it is. All right, that's everything for this haul. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're not already subscribed. If you have any questions about any of the products that I talked about, you can definitely ask me down below or DM me on Instagram, and hit that notification bell if you want to be notified when I upload. And I will see you next time. Bye.